Who knows what evil lurks in the heart of games? The Shadow Knows.
Hi, I'm The Shadow Knows, and I'm back with another Let's Play the Amiga video. Tonight I play the game Girl Actions. And a special thank to Mark the Morose for pointing me to this game, and it's not even more especially thanks for telling me where to download it. Yeah, and what do you expect from a game called Girl Actions? Galaxian! So it's more Girl Actions. They should have called it Girl Actions. Yeah, this is. And I think I will make a special thumbnail for this. Probably take the girl from the title screen for that. So that people that search for it don't get the Galaxian part as a preview. Yeah, it's not as good as the real Galaxian. Not even as great as Hemorrhoid, which, yeah, for some reason I watched it on my PC and I had a real giggle again when I saw the videos that YouTube suggested me along Hemorrhoid. So yeah, would be interesting to see the YouTube suggestions to Girl Actions. Yeah, the game is probably really just made for fun. No real effort put into it. You can really feel it. Yeah, but again, it's from a cover disc. I think it was Amiga format. I've forgotten it again. And yeah, as a freebie, probably keeps you busy for a couple of minutes. And I was incredibly spoiled as a kid. Since I used to play crack games and I had quite good connections, I was pretty much able to play any game I wanted. There was never a shortage of games for me. But if I really had to pay for, especially for my Amiga games, which were a lot more expensive than the C64 games, there were no $1.99 games on the Amiga. I paid, let's convert this to Mastertronic games. I think I played 5 Mastertronic games for a 10-pack of the first 3.5-inch discs I bought. So, yeah. £10 for 10 discs, so even pirated games were quite expensive in the early Amiga days. It got better later. never as cheap as on the C64. But yeah, the Amiga always was sort of a diva. Expensive. And really not always a pleasure to use. It had its moods. I found especially the discs on the Amiga were really vulnerable to damages. And then there was the virus problem. So if you weren't careful, especially if you copied a lot of games with other classmates, you got your computer infected. And I did not turn off my Amiga every time I loaded a new game. But I had all my discs write protected, and if I played a game where I had to save, I always turned off my Amiga before, so the virus in memory was leaving. And I also checked all my disks with a virus checker, so I was quite paranoid concerning getting infected. And I never really had any problems with viruses. Think I got a Lama Exterminator once on one of the discs I got from the mate, but I don't think it damaged any of my games, so was lucky. And why am I playing this? It's just your very average, very basic Galaxian clone, which only stands out because, yeah, they called it girl actions instead of Galaxians. Galaxian. But again, I'm playing this for 5 or 10 minutes now. I had a test run before I started the video. So yeah, even keeps me occupied for 10 minutes. So yeah, well done. As a joke, it's okay. Oi, oi, oi. Rather play a real Galaxian game on basically any systems. I like to play the Galaxian on my 168-in-1 handheld NES on a chip thingamabob. It's one of the more playable game on this handheld. But at least I have it for more than half a year. I regularly use it and it still works fine. So yeah, for 15 bucks, not a bad thing. Even though the audio is horrible, when I play it on the go, I usually have the audio turned off anyways, so it doesn't really matter. And what would you expect from a color portable NES with a built-in color screen and 168 games built in? But I'm not talking about this game anymore, and I'm not going to play this any longer. Yeah, that was Girl's Action, or Girl Actions. Hope you enjoyed this video, and thanks for watching.